Hello, everybody. We're at the freaking Nintendo Direct, and I'm gonna turn my TV down because I'm hanging out with some at a good stream on my TV. So I just wanna kind of wanna look at the Nintendo Direct and stuff. I like how it's structured now. Monster, it's a new Monster Hunter game. Yeah. Monster Hunter Stories. Did they just make a Pokemon version of Monster Hunter? Looks like. Me and Bugsy are still on the island, and yeah, both of us are shirtless right now. It's hot in this tropical island, man. It's just fucking hot. I didn't play Yo-Gai Watch 1. Neither did I. I hear it's cool though. I hear good things about it. Yeah, I wanna give it a shot. I wanna see how different it is compared to, you know what. Ooh. I might actually give this a play. Concept. Coldsip? What the crap is this game? It's a cardboard game. I'll get it on my 3DS if you get it on yours, Bugsy. Bugsy, you thinking what I'm thinking? Making our one RPG dream in reality. Yep. Bob Muffin. Bob Muffin Adventures. It's fucking awesome, man. They need to make some for the Switch though. It'd be cool. Metopia. Dude. Okay, this looks kind of fun. That's it. Is this something you download or turn up, bro?
Imagine casting one of your best friends as a gritty warrior, or seeing your boss as a pop star. In Utopia, you'll have that power, and many, many more, when the game launches later this year.
We go. Okay, Bugsy, we'll have fun with that.
Shadows of Valentia will take the series back to its roots. But one modern enhancement will expand your adventure.
Sweet.
Downloadable content. Some of it will be free, and some will be paid. But no matter what, you can expect new maps and dungeons.
Ooh, some will be paid. Some will be free.
While earning you more experience, items.
Yeah, they said the magic word, free.
Character backstories. This content can be purchased individually, in packs, or all at once through a season pass.
Guys, you can access. We're sitting here, and there's like a big ass flag like in the
full details, including release timing.
It's gonna be cool.
This year marks Kirby's 25th anniversary. In celebration, we've prepared a few fun little surprises. First, the Team Kirby Clash Deluxe game is headed to Nintendo eShop on Nintendo 3DS. In this co-op action game, Kirby must unite to do battle with giant enemies.
Just select Kirby.
And form a team from four roles: Sword Hero, Hammer Lord, Beam Mage, or Dr. Humor.
Oh, that's cool. They got little classes. That's cool. It's fucking awesome. Ooh, Bugsy, I wish we didn't blow our... I'm actually mad that we didn't blow our... cash on, like, Breath of the Wild, which was totally deserved. But, like, fuck, I would like to play that, too. The stages are bigger than in Kirby 3D Rumble, and the challenges too. Wipe out entire troops of enemies all at once, and go for a bronze, silver, or gold. DDD! Oh my god, DDD is huge, Bugsy. What the fuck? A new multiplayer action game is in development for Nintendo 3DS systems. This title will be available in stores and on Nintendo Shop this holiday. So you could say that 2017 is Kirby's big year. Oh, good, 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 good. In an odd twist of fate, a box is the last defense against annihilation. Luckily, Cutie is no ordinary box. Adorable phenomena known as Q-Babies lend him 4 new powers in the final game of the Box Boy trilogy. 3 boxes to climb, hover, warp, and...
I've never played this, so I don't really know how I'm supposed to feel about that. And destroy the black smoke once and for all. Like, I guess... If I actually played the thing, and was actually a fan of this, I'd be like, oh my god, it's the final. And dress for success with Amiibo costumes. If you have save data of the first 2 games, you can play this one with a Game Boy or monochromatic filter on.
Try a demo for all 3 games today. And check out boxboy.nintendo.com for more info. Or better yet, just purchase and download the latest installment in the series. Created by Hal Laboratory, the developers behind the Kirby series. Bye Bye Box Boy launches today on Nintendo eShop for Nintendo 3DS. 3 new amiibo figures of Link from past entries of the
No one talked about Splatoon. Store shelf, June 23rd. Yeah, I was really hoping for a Splatoon announcement, but I guess not. And Bayonetta will roll into stores on July 21st. Each one will be available in 2 versions. But I want the Bayonetta one. Yeah, you didn't sound creepy at all, Bugsy. Next up, let's reach a little deeper into our next title. Yeah, I don't care. Please take a look. Arms!
Hi there, ladies and
motherfucking arms.
I'm Biff, your trusty arms commentator.
Biff, my boy. Gonna be our new friend.
I've always gained the talk about the arms game. The one with the weapon
so much arms.
Extendable arms. So let's get into it.
Oh, yeah. Look at them arms. Bugsy. Arms, you know what they say with a girl with a lot of arms. No, I think you made that shit up.
The feature is the weaponry fighters attached to their fists, called arms.
Arms.
There are standard glove-type arms.
Glove-type?
Multi-shot arms that really cause a ruckus.
I'm gonna use that.
Specialized curving arms for cornering opponents. And powerful heavyweight class arms, just to name a few.
Whip-type.
Each arm has a special
attribute to activate. We don't even got a switch yet, man, but I want this.
To knock them down with fire. Stun and electrify your rival with lightning. Blow away the competition with a tornado of wind. And freeze your foe to slow him down with ice. You get the point. You want more, right? Perfectly normal. Try the Get Arms service, courtesy of the Arms League.
Get Arms service.
You earn can be used for a chance to unlock new arms. The more you fight, sweet, the more arms you have in your arsenal.
Man, we're just going to be like, you know, we're gonna be actually throwing punches and shit. Just gonna be like,
There's a veritable treasure trove of arms.
Yonk is gonna kill it.
Fighters who use them are pretty tricky themselves.
You know how he is. It's gonna be like, gonna break fucking TVs.
The
and
rocket
shit.
Girl who never flinches. The elusive ninja.
As a girl? I thought that was a dude. You thought that yellow.
Ribbon girl. Their unique traits are as distinguished as the fighters themselves. Not to mention, each one can mix and match any 2 available arms. That's right, fighting fans. The game gets deeper and deeper as players discover new combinations of fighters and arms.
It's gonna be fun. Now, get a load of this. See, this is the kind of, see, people keep saying that ARMS is like the most generic thing you can call this thing. But me? I don't know. ARMS has grown on me. Yeah, I'm kind of with, yeah, I'm with you on that.
Now it's time to get amped up as I introduce to you a new contender, the Ramen Bomber.
The Ramen Min Min. Okay, that made me think about Minnie. That shouldn't make me think about my dead dog. It shouldn't, but it did.
When she dodges in the air, she can also kick down enemy attacks.
Oh shit!
Wait.
They are going to abuse this.
Big misconception. Min Min is living proof of that. She can throw her opponent, and her left arm can transform into a dragon. This augmented arm can maintain a longer charge. So
holy shit!
Out of your rivals. Anyone getting hungry? I wish my arms were made of noodles.
Ooh, I want.
Next up is the enthusiastic.
They gotta make me want some noodles.
After charging up, release to initiate a shockwave that can repel attacks with his overpowered.
Oh, yeah, and this island is Popeye's and this one pizza place.
His opponent's punches, then delivering powerful counterattacks. When his health drops,
so yeah, we had chicken and pizza.
His never say die attitude kicks in.
It's fucking beautiful.
His punches will stay perma charged. His slick back spring hair isn't just for show. He actually gets stronger after bouncing back from a desperate situation.
Oh, yeah.
You know, I feel a fight coming. Guess I'll serve as your commentator. Let's see. Min Min has a fiery Ram Ram on the right and a fiery dragon on the left. She must
hey,
have
can
a hot temper.
Anybody get the fiery dragon? Because I'm going to probably use that.
Slap-a-mander on the right.
I'm going to use spring and probably that slap-a-mander right there.
Well, let's take up arms.
Just think about it.
Okay, here's
those two arms
right
can get
away.
People off here.
There's her dragon arm. With her dragon arm and that dragon arm, really looks like a real dragon. The dragon roasts opponents with a high-powered laser. There's a bit of delay before it fires, but its power is exceptional. She's got Springman cornered with her combo attacks, and a left,
Springman.
A right, and a wait! Springman's counterattack has kicked in after deflecting a shockwave.
This is gonna be awesome.
No choice but
I want this game so
noodles.
Bad. Man, see, like,
to pummel each other.
People are like, no, Bugsy, this game is just generic. I'm like, nah, man. From what I've heard, this is deep as fuck.
Carefully timing the gaps between punches is an important technique.
So cool.
Wow,
Bugsy, this is fucking cool.
You'll notice Min Min carefully arcing her punches with her Ram Ram. She must be trying to rack up small hits over time.
You know we're gonna have to wear those freaking wrist straps if we're gonna play this thing. Yeah, but I don't care. You know how notoriously hard they are putting on.
Her left arm is really charged up.
Holy shit.
While they expertly dodge incoming attacks. And here comes the finisher. Wait, no! Instead, she avoids the counterattack with the guard. Talk about clarity under pressure, but just how much damage can her right arm take?
I'd have been like, I'd have used that arm right there. I would have used that dragon arm right there and said, Dr. Octopus.
Yes! She manages to recover. Her kick is smacking down his arms, and now a simultaneous punch. Both fighters are desperately trying
this
to
recover. This is pretty deep for a fucking game about, you know, arms, man. I mean, hell, I'll call this the new Nintendo boxing game, even though it's not really boxing.
Springman's last hope is his special comeback. He'll never give up.
No, Tim, this, I mean, no, Bugsy, it's boxing on crack.
Yes, she did, thanks to her dragon's laser. Min Min steals the win.
You called me by our sister's name. It's weird.
So how that
I don't know, slip of the tongue, bro.
To their arms and abilities. There's an arsenal of
the little bit of the heat is getting
the
to me.
Is heating up. Now that
shit,
is
this
arms.
Is cool.
And when I say rivalry, I'm not just talking about one-on-one matches. Sometimes you just gotta shake things up.
Two-on-two, you say? Ooh.
We got a lot more.
You thinking what I'm thinking, Bugsy? Kicking some people's asses online?
Stretch the limits of your fighting skills when ARMS launches June 16th.
Until next time, June 16th, man. We gotta get a Switch right around then.
Alongside the launch of ARMS, we'll release a new color of Joy-Con and Joy-Con strap, neon yellow.
Neon yellow.
And we're also releasing a Joy-Con attachment that extends the battery life. It's nice to have when you want to play for a long time without charging. Next, we'll speedrun
the Joy-Con battery pack? Ooh.
Alright.
Oh, Mario Kart Deluxe. We're gonna hear about Mario Kart Deluxe.
Mario Kart 8 Deluxe.
And then we're gonna hear about Black Forces!
While introducing a huge battle mode featuring all new battle forces.
Holy shit!
Plus more characters, okay. Parts, and tracks.
How long have we been going on Tokomaru? Eggsy? I'm about to say, our freaking keyboard may not be doing what I think it's doing.
Online mode has a fun way of keeping things fresh.
Holy shit, Bowser. Holy shit.
And other players can switch between random assortments of tracks. Choose battle, and you'll even switch between modes, like good old balloon battle.
That's a good thing, and play some Mario Kart.
For a more
personal game,
the rules, the items, the CPUs, and more. You can even create or enter a full-fledged in-game tournament. Speaking of,
we
will be hosting two of our own, one for racing and one for battle, to celebrate the launch of Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. Stay tuned for more info.
If we can get, race begins, man, that'd be fun if we could get in on that. The tournament? Yeah.
Ultra Street Fighter 2, the final challenges, marks nearly 10 years since fans have seen a new iteration of the beloved classic. It can throw down as one of the original fighters in all-new HD graphics.
Which I like.
Ultra Street Fighter 2 also
playable
characters, the first new additions in the classic roster in over 20
years. Violet and Ken.
Evil succumbs to the murderer of Setsui Nohata, and M. Bison has brainwashed his friend, creating Violet Ken.
Oh, brainwashed him. Because I'm like, I know freaking Kendo got the Dark Hado.
Online multiplayer competitions. For a change of pace, the all-new Way of the Hado mode lets you throw a Hadouken from a first-person perspective.
Ooh. I probably want to play this. I want to get this now. If we can throw Hadoukens at fucking M. Bison, you guys gave us what we really wanted. Something we never thought we wanted. That's the thing about the Switch. It gives you things that you never thought you wanted.
Ooh. It's a game about placing blocks and going on adventures.
Yeah.
Explore randomly generated worlds and build amazing things from the unlimited resources.
Show me what you got in the Switch edition. I already know about Minecraft. I play it religiously on PlayStation 3. Just tell me what you guys got. I remember when you made a boat, you were like, yeah.
Nintendo Switch Pro Controller. Nintendo and Minecraft fans alike will also be happy to learn
that
the Mario Matcha Pack will be launching on the Nintendo Switch console. Play and explore a world full of classic characters and places from the Mario universe. Minecraft Nintendo Switch Edition, including the Super Mario Matcha Pack, will launch on Nintendo eShop May 11th.
Does it come with it?
Happy building. Neo Geo Masterpiece.
Ooh, we're getting close to Sonic Forces. We'll learn a little something about Sonic Forces by looking at the Switch. This is what I'm talking about.
Look out for these other Golden Age greats coming soon. 99% in the evil clutches of Eggman and his terrifying new powers. But never fear.
Okay.
Sonic is here to face the danger. Now fight back. Free the world from Eggman using the blue blur of stylish high-speed moves. And who is this alternate version of Sonic, summoned to this world by Eggman? He
survived all the traps and returned to his home world? I'm gonna cry!
Comes up as well.
The new character!
Sonic Forces races to the west, holiday 2017.
Foxy!
There's one more Sonic speeding this way. After more than 4 years, new installment in the classic series' original style is almost here. In addition to brand new stages,
folks, Bugsy's speechless right now, so hold up.
Sonic Mania will dash onto Nintendo Switch. Project Maturu.
I'm taking over. I'm overcome with emotion. I'm overcome with a lot of emotion right now.
Stomp a panel and it'll change. Fight to win by changing the most panels to your color and blow up your opponents. Sometimes flipping panels can yield items.
Guys.
Can boost your movement speed and panel flipping.
Guys. Being on this island, we brought our family in here too, for the most part. Teleportation and all that shit. But anyways, and this looks pretty up. This looks pretty cool. I mean, it reminds me of a Mario Party.
Is headed to Nintendo Switch with an all-star cast of characters from the series.
Oh, all my freaking fates fans! You better be ready. You better be hyped. I'm hyped. Are you hyped? Are you feeling it? Are you feeling it like I'm feeling it? Because I'm feeling it, and I'm feeling it so well. Oh, yeah. Yeah, Ansakamaru is a Fate fan, for those of you that don't know. Yes, I am.
You'll follow the Princess Overlord of the gorgeous Netherworld.
This guy. I love this series. I'm fucking in love with this series. You guys don't know why. I'm just in love with this fucking series. I want to hold it in my arms. You know what I'm saying?
Puyo Puyo Tetris.
Bugsy.
While you're probably familiar with Tetris,
Puyo Puyo and Tetris. Puyo Puyo. Oh, motherfucker, you wanna go? Bring it on, you motherfucker! I will take you on.
Puyo fall from the top of your board and collect.
Bro, you know I'm still a Tetris pro, motherfucker. Puyos,
but unlike Tetris, your goal isn't to create a line, but to gather a clump of the same colored Puyos.
You motherfucker, I'll show you who's the best, motherfucker. I will show you who's the best. I will show it to you. I will show it to you, and I will beat you. All right, whatever, Ansakamaru. I'm ready whenever you are, man. When I get this game, we'll go. You're an asshole. I'm going to take you down.
Well, don't worry.
I'm still a Tetris Attack Pro, my brother.
Well. Give it a try.
In both versions. Well, let's go then, you. Well, let's go then, you asshole.
Ever is coming to Nintendo Switch. Now up to 6 players can enjoy Monopoly in a whole new world.
Yay, Monopoly! I love Monopoly. You guys.
With HD Rumble.
Yeah, but like our family does not share the same kind of enthusiasm that Bugsy has.
New boards to discover. And new rules that will change the
game. Oh yeah.
For more additional content, new twists and interactions as you take over the whole board when the game launches this fall.
This is fucking awesome.
Rayman Legends Definitive Edition is the ultimate version of the award-winning game. Pick your favorite character and get absorbed once again into the mythical Glade of Dreams. The game must run, jump,
oh my god,
your way through different worlds to save the day.
Oh my god.
For each legendary painting. Exclusive to the Nintendo Switch, the Kung Fu Experience now offers a solo mode and a tournament
Sweet
mode pitting up to
Jesus.
Eight teams against
each other.
Oh
my god.
You can connect two consoles for playing in local co-op. Get ready
connect
for a lot
two
of
consoles
when the game launches later this year.
For co-op? Really?
If your game for something different,
you know, okay.
Then THQ Nordic has your back.
Oh my god, this is so cool. That was so cool.
By Grasshopper Manufacturer.
You're still overcome with emotion on Sonic Forces. We saw the new character! Oh my god, guys. All this is excellent and awesome. And, you know, it's a lot of things I never thought I wanted. And I do, and it's so fucking cool. There's gonna be a fate game on the Switch. There's gonna be a goddamn fate game on the Switch, my boner Bugsy.
And even deeper into its turn-based combat.
I'm deeply aroused right now.
Switch in late summer.
Ew. Nah, man, I am deeply Payday aroused.
The bad guys is as sweet of a gig as ever.
And Payday for the Switch, you say?
You and three other players stand together for intense co-op action. Criminal underworld for bigger jobs and better payday. Use the cash you stash to customize your character with new skills that change the way you play. A huge amount of Payday, the most popular Namco games of all time, are headed to Nintendo Switch.
Sorry, it wasn't live for a minute.
You can play classics like Pac-Man, Galaga, or Splatterhouse anytime, anywhere.
See, the Switch is for everybody at this point. It's giving you everything you would want. So no fucking PC gamers better not say, oh, it doesn't have this, it doesn't have that, or any freaking Sony fans better not say that either. Because you get everything. They're giving us everything we could possibly want, everything the hardcore gamers want, everything the casuals want, everything.
We're happy to confirm that limited quantities of the standalone Nintendo Switch dock will be available for purchase May 19th. You can hook up an extra dock to a separate TV, so you can switch from one to the other without unplugging your main setup. If you're interested, it's available. You've been waiting for. If you're 18 years or older and based in the U.S., you can register your team at battlefy.com.
We can't go. Yeah, but we're out of practice. We are so out of practice. Oh my god, this is so good. Everything is good. Bugsy? We got some footage to study. Yeah, we do. What? Oh no. This ain't what I think it is. Oh, Bugsy, it probably is. Oh no, this seems kind of familiar. Like we've seen it. This seems familiar. What is it? Oh, it's just another Splatoon thing, okay. it's just another Splatoon thing. I was like, oh, okay, I thought it was something else. That's how it's going around Bugsy being idiots for you, you know? We're just dumb. Guzzo Industries, the brighter future awaits. Me and Specs Fell Play.
Are your regulatory systems functioning? On behalf of the Squid Research Lab, I certainly hope so, because the findings we're about to present may be startling. Oh, that's right. You may be wondering about the Squid Research Lab. Well, we research squids in a lab, and other things too, like that strange video.
So...
what you saw seemed a bit unusual.
Yes.
Research indicates that freelance power egg collection is becoming quite popular among inklings in a new mode called Salmon Run. Our fearless researchers went on location and captured this curious activity live on camera. Now, we share our findings with the world. For the first time on film, we can see this remote location, separated from Inkopolis, on the other side of the ocean.
Wow.
This man-made island is a hotspot for freelance power egg collectors. Amazing. Inkling super jumping to the island. We completed that four inklings make a team, just like in Turf War.
Okay, if there's no humans, who's in the Squid Research Lab? Maybe they're just researchers from our time looking at the future. Because they're kind of interested in this kind of thing.
It's a power egg collector.
I mean, hell, I used to be a scientist on Sakamaro. This is the kind of, what the fuck are those?
And it's not just one way.
Holy shit, they made a horde mode. Motherfucking salmons. I never trusted them, and they taste disgusting.
Some sort of salmonid. To tell the truth, it's unlike anything we've ever seen.
What the fuck? Oh my god.
It's a special kind of boss salmonid that Inklings are paid a bounty to hunt. I'm afraid our brave squid friends are no match for this beast. At least, not with their current strategy. Ooh, one of the Inklings is down.
Oh no.
And another.
Buzzy, I'm having squid PTSD right now.
Oh, I see.
Really?
Gets
I don't know why.
That inkling can be resuscitated. Freelancing does have
with ink?
Mm-hmm. Communication is key because inklings that work together win together. Unless they don't. What an honor it is to witness this incredible struggle. How odd. These eggs have a rare appearance, even among power eggs. Could they be golden eggs? And now it looks like the inklings are transporting these golden eggs to a containment unit in the center of the site.
Sweet.
This is the freelancer's ultimate objective, to harvest these golden eggs and haul them to Inkopolis. Indeed, after many trials and tribulations,
salmon
the inklings have collected
though.
Their golden egg prize and fulfilled their corporate
interesting.
Agenda.
Very.
Here is the harsh reality of one suspicious part-time job. Why would such a dismal occupation be so popular among inklings?
It's the only way we can have bounty hunters in this world.
It might be due to the rewards. I've heard they're quite, fresh, is it?
More fresh, you say? That is intriguing.
What a day for science. If we compile any new information, you will be the first to know. We're planning to release a research report on the ongoing battle with Octarians, so...
The Octarians are still around, Bugsy.
That reminds me, we have one last report.
It matters not to me, my brother.
That new Splatoon
it's time.
Amiibo will be released. There
will
are
be time.
New figures.
Will you be ready, bro? Will you be ready?
Inkling Boy and Inkling Squid.
I'll be ready, man.
When you tap these amiibo, the figure character will appear in-game and befriend you.
And we gotta do challenges, am I right?
Befriend an amiibo character, and they'll remember your favorite outfits, weapons, gear, and option sets. Tap your amiibo on the customization menu screen.
Yeah, I didn't get a lot of Splatoon amiibos, but I might. Hey, do Kelly and, would Kelly and, Marine still work? It's
to conduct your own research, try snapping a photo with your amiibo friend. That way you can both wear your favorite outfits.
What the fuck? Okay, this is pretty cool.
Then you can share your photos with human friends on social media via the Nintendo Switch album.
Ha! We do have Miiverse. It's just a different thing. People are like, I didn't want Miiverse. Yeah, we still got it. We still got it. This is not called Miiverse. I want these too. I still want these too. Yeah, they best squid girls, you know what I'm saying? Best squid girls.
Well, fellow researchers, today's presentation is over. We look forward to sharing more research in the future.
Bugsy?
Thanks for, forgive my apparent short-term memory loss. I have one last fact for you.
Ooh, what do you got?
Splatoon 2 launches July 21st. And a new Amiibo release that same day.
Yes, yes, yes.
That's
okay, it's in July. It's in July because people get saying August.
I hope you
and I'm like, why August? You ain't going to give us enough time to play it online and stuff. Oh, Bugsy, I got a boner. I got a boner too, buddy. Mostly with all the Sonic and new stuff, because I'm like, new things to theorize, new things to talk about. I feel so alive. Guys. I'm Bugsy, and I'm on Sakamaru. We are the Chaos Bros, and oh my fucking Jesus God shit, what the fuck, but yes, this is so awesome, but we're gonna get out of here, because me and Bugsy have stuff to think about, mostly on the Sonic Forces route, because we looked at the silhouette of the character, and it's not Sally. If it's Sally, We didn't have a good look, but I think it's not. So we're gonna go. And 7-Run is basically horde mode, like a zombie horde mode. And yeah, I'm out of here. We're out of here. Both of us. See ya. This is the Chaos Bro saying. Yeah, we go. Me and Sakamaro, before we do another video today, we're gonna go to several parts of the island and make our boners go away for a bit. But we'll be back, folks. We'll be back. See you guys later.